Hi everyone, hope you're all doing well and you're feeling ready to get on with the next part of this tutorial. Once again, I'm a little bit late, so sorry about that, but we will continue now and hopefully get this hedgehog finished in this video. So, everything you need to know is in the description and let's just get started with this part. Okay, first things first, I think I might add a bit of an orangey colour to these spines. I feel like it needs a bit of warmth, so I'm just going to use burnt ochre and just add a little bit into some of these spines. It's not till you come back and you're like, could do with adding a bit of something else in there. I'm not going to spend too long doing this, just want to add a little bit. A little bit more through this bit. Okay. Let's add a little bit to these that I've not quite finished yet. Very windy still. Storm Eunice has not quite left us. Right, that'll do for now. And I'm going to carry on adding some dark sepia and burnt umber into these spines here. So let's go for dark sepia. And I'm just going to carry on what I was doing before in the other video, just building up those little spaces between the spines. I think we'll probably add a bit of black in as well afterwards. I think it just needs an extra bit of depth. Yeah, I think this is going to be another one where I don't really need to say too much. Obviously, when we get down to the grass, I'll explain what I'm doing, but it's very repetitive for the most part. Holding my pencil quite tightly for this so that I get a bit of a firmer pressure. If you struggle to get a firm pressure, try holding your pencil a bit different. So if I want to do a light pressure, I hold it like this with the pencil like loosely sitting in my fingers there. And then if I want a firmer pressure, I sort of grab the pencil a bit more like that. And it just helps to get that sort of deeper colour, firmer pressure. But yeah, I naturally press on quite hard, so I don't find it too difficult to get a firm pressure, but I know a lot of people naturally just don't really press on very hard, which is absolutely fine. Sort of everyone's different and you don't have to press on hard if you don't want to, but if you do, that is just a way that I find it easier doing. But yeah, sometimes I press on hard, sometimes I don't. It depends what you're drawing, really.
kind of darken them up at the bottom a little bit. It's all very confusing, but just take your time. And it doesn't matter if you don't get every single spine perfect. That's better. Get in there. Gonna add a little bit around these spines here. get a little bit extra definition.
Okay, let's add a bit more of that burnt ochre. And I'm going to add some burnt umber. I'm just going to blend it through some of these spines a little bit. Not sure it's actually doing much. Not really doing a lot. I think it's a waste of time. Alright, let's just move straight on to the black. And I'm gonna start just blending it through and darkening up some of these spines. I'm not going to put it everywhere. I want it to look quite like varied and like more interesting, so I'm just going to put it in the odd little place. Add a little bit more. Spray there. Starting to look better. Maybe I needed a little bit more than I thought I did.
I'm going to start down here just to keep my mind like occupied and keep it interesting. Gonna bring a bit more up,
just for a bit.
Carry on bringing it up here. Don't mind me keep changing which bit I'm doing, but it just keeps my brain switched on, basically. Just make sure that you keep sharpening your pencil. Keep it nice and sharp. And just keep going. Now that this is nearly done, I'm going to have to think of another subject for the next tutorial series. I've got quite a lot of suggestions from you all, so I have everything written down in a notebook. Every time someone comments asking for certain subjects, so I'll have a look at that and pick something. I wish there was a way of doing everyone's suggestions like immediately, but these take so long to film and edit and whatnot that it'll just have to be a little bit at a time. I know that some people prefer drawing wildlife, some people prefer pets, so I need to try and do a bit for everyone. But yeah, I think my most watched tutorial is the robin so far, which is interesting, but they are such gorgeous birds, it makes sense.
I might add a little bit more burnt ochre,
just to blend through some of these spines a little bit.
And I might add a little bit of nougat,
just to blend through a tiny bit more. Add a little bit more through these furry bits.
And then let's move on to this little bit here. So I'm just gonna clean it up. And then let's use the warm grey one as the base. Like that, and then I'm going to use the nougat to start mapping in some more of those fur strokes. Just paying attention to the direction that it's going in. Sharpen it a bit.
then I'm just going to bring these little spines down a bit more. Like that. Let's use the dark sepia. And I'm just going to sort of bring it out through this fur to try and connect the bit where the spine ends to where this fur starts, if that makes sense. It's quite like strandy, there's like gaps between the bits of fur. Just give it a sharpen. Start bringing it through this part here. Actually quite dark around this bit. Bring it up a little bit more. Definitely need starting up on this bottom bit where it meets the grass. Like a really dark shadow. It's not until you've done more of a drawing that you realise you actually need to go like way darker than you initially thought. Blend a bit more through here. And I'm just going to finish this bit off. And I'm going to add a bit of burnt umber, try and blend it together a bit better. Now the dreaded grass that we need to do. I must admit, I don't love drawing grass. I do find it quite difficult, but we'll just take it slow and see how it goes. Right, so I think the colours that I'm going to use for the grass are May Green, Grass Green, ironically, and Chrome Oxide Green. There's probably a multitude of different colours that you could use for this, but I think these look like they're pretty close to the picture. So I'm just going to clean that up and then start adding the grass. So sometimes I use a base of ivory to create like a yellowy tone, but I think for this I'm just going to go in with the green first and then see how it looks. So I'm going to use the May Green to begin with, and I like to think of drawing grass a bit like drawing fur. So I'm using the same sort of technique and just going to start building up some texture with it. And I'm just doing strokes, sort of like going in different directions to keep it interesting. And I'm just going to start building that up all the way across the bottom. And this grass is quite chunky on the picture, but I might just do it a bit more like thin little pieces of grass, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Blend it out at the bottom. So as you can see, I'm literally just doing it like I'm drawing fur, and I find that to be the easiest way to draw grass. Doesn't always go to plan, but yeah, it's just one of them things, you have to get used to drawing it, and I used to get it wrong all the time because I had no idea how to draw it, and then as soon as you start thinking of it like fur, it's just the same technique. So I do like to sort of blur it out a bit at the bottom, so I'll show you how I do that. I like to just alternate the length of the strokes, and then it looks a bit more like it's fading out rather than just like a solid line where the grass ends. So I think I'll bring it down to about here. And then I'll bring it out a bit at the side. And you can overlap the fur a little bit in places if you like. So like I said, I'm just sort of alternating the direction to try and keep it interesting. I might do a few little bits just sort of sticking out there and just gradually fade it. I might need to bring it down a little bit more. And then I'll bring it on this left hand side. Underneath the face. It does take a while to build it up, but it's worth putting the time in to make it look nice and soft. Yeah, I don't tend to like it to be in a complete straight line. I like to try and make it a bit more of an interesting shape.
in there.
And you can do as little or as much grass as you like.
Don't feel like you have to do it exactly the same.
I'm just gonna
do a few little hairs. pieces of grass. Make it a nice shape and gradually sort of fade out a little bit. Okay, let's now go in with the grass green, and it's just to add another little green tone in there, make it interesting. I'm just going to add that. Sort of more towards the top. That's a nice vivid green colour. And then I'm going to use the chrome oxide green to start adding in a bit of detail and make this grass look more like actual grass. So I'm just treating it like I would fur and just adding that next layer on top. Like I said, I'm sort of making this grass a bit thinner than on the picture. So I'm doing those little pointy V shapes to get that nice texture of the grass. I'm not pressing on hard either, so I'm just really lightly blending it in. It's quite a dark colour, so you don't really need to press that hard. Might just bring that grass green
down a little bit.
And then back to that chrome oxide green.
Just carry on building up that texture.
Bring it down a bit more of that grass green. Maybe a bit more of that May green. And a bit more of the grass green.
Just want it to fade out nicely at the bottom.
Then back to that chrome oxide green. Few bits, so come in on top of the hedgehog. And I'm going to darken it up a little bit here. And then I'm going to add some dark sepia to darken up the shadowy area, sort of like between the grass and the hedgehog. So I'm just going to start blending that in. Let's bring it all together.
nice and sharp. Doing those little like pointy kind of shapes. And bring it all the way under that face. Carry on bringing it down a little bit here too. Try and sort of blend that bit together. I need to add some dark sepia to this whole bit where the hedgehog meets the grass. Thank you.
I want to add a bit more chrome oxide green. Bringing it down a little bit more. Bit more here. And some more May green. And I might add a bit more dark sepia. Add a bit more under the face there. And some more just under this bit here. Definitely needed a bit darker. And I might blend a bit of black in there too.
Just add a little bit more dark sepia around here.
And some black, just to darken this bit up a little bit more.
Starting in this bit up too. Pressing on a little bit harder to get some extra definition down here. I'm just going to add a little bit along this bottom bit here. And
and a little bit more dark sepia. I might just bring it out to this right hand side a little bit more with the May green. Smudge and a bit more of the grass green. Chrome oxide green. And if you really want, you can go in with the putty eraser and just sort of blur out that edge a little bit more. Like that. There we go. I think I can pretty much call that done now. You could go on forever, couldn't you? But happy with how that's looking, and I'd love to see your version of this if you draw it for yourself. You can email me or send me a picture on Instagram or Facebook or whatever, and I'd love to see your little hedgehog. So yeah, I'm just adding a little bit more to this right hand side, but subscribe if you want to see more videos like this if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next one. Do you know what? I'm gonna add a little bit more grass to this left side. I'm just using the May green. The grass green. Chrome oxide green. Dark sepia. Bit of black. Better. Okay, now we're done with that. So please make sure to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe to see more, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.